Hello there! Today I have another luxury car for you. The all-new 2021 Mercedes E63S AMG. It's finally here, and just like every AMG, this one is a force to be reckoned with. And of course, we won't look at the standard E63 AMG. No, we fuel junkies will look at the most powerful E-Class there is, the E63S AMG of course. As always, enjoy this review and tell us afterwards what you think of the new E63S. So then, the 2021 model of the new AMG E-Class starts from €110,000. Nothing new for existing Mercedes customers. It has got a few new changes though, let me go over them now. On the back, you will have a nice little spoiler, a rear diffuser which helps in pointing out the fake quad exhaust, it's fake but it looks cool, and if you have seen the two real ones behind them, you will understand why they put fake downpipes, okay? The wheel arches are wider than on the standard E-Class, making the car in total 27mm wider than a standard car, and they help in giving the car a bigger, more sporty look. Also, the standard 20-inch alloys help with that too. Let's stay on the outside for a second. On the front, normally you would hear me rant about some fake vans, but this time I can't do it. Better to say, I don't have to do it. Here, every air vent you see has a purpose, namely the purpose of cooling. And if you have the Night Edition pack, the outside around the windows will be black and you get tint back windows, for more privacy. What won't give you privacy though is the most important badge on this car. It sits right on each side of the hood. It says here V8 B-Turbo 4MATIC Plus. That already says it all. In the AMG version here, you have sports air suspension with 3 different settings and also adaptive dampers as standard. Which should in theory be more comfortable than the old suspension, because there people were complaining about too much stiffness. And with great power comes great responsibility. And so this car needs damn good brakes. They are an upgraded version of the standard brakes from the normal E-Class, with 6 piston calibers, which are painted red, and single piston calibers on the back. And if that still doesn't fit your needs, then you can upgrade them to carbon ceramic brakes. But that will cost you. I don't know exactly how much, and as a car channel moderator I really should know that. Okay, I will look it up. It will cost you a minimum of €15,000 for an AMG braking kit. There you have it. Of course, the seats are AMG sport seats and the dashboard as well as the center console are made out of carbon fiber. And 360 parking cameras are also standard in the AMG E63S. And because this is a saloon car, you still have enough room in the back to carry a few passengers with you. Or you decide yourself for the estate car. Then there is even more space. Last thing before we go over the engine and stuff is the trunk. 540 liters in the back and more than 600 if you have the estate car are there for you to use. The E63S AMG is powered by, who could have guessed it, a twin-turbo 4-liter V8 petrol engine. Which has its turbochargers in the center of the engine bay, so the way that the air has to go is reduced to a minimum, making the car more powerful. It comes with 612 horsepower over the 570 of the standard E63 AMG and has over 850 Nm of torque. And here, on the engine, you see a little plate which tells you the name of the guy who has hand-built this engine, just for you. This power has to be delivered somehow to the road underneath. This is done by a 9-speed automatic gearbox with multi-clutches, so apparently more than 2. Also, this car can send up to 100% of its power to the back wheels, and it's already rear-wheel biased, so you can imagine what happens next. Plus, this car is equipped with a drift mode. To enable it, turn off the stability control, go in manual mode for the gearbox, pull both pedals, and then pull the right pedal to confirm. What this does is the front wheels will totally disengage and leave all the power to the back ones. Sadly, I must say that due to the new regulations and laws, over the noise that comes out of these cars, Mercedes has put a soft limiter in here. So no more posing or showing off at the red lights, sorry guys. But although the engine will only rev up to 4000 RPM when standing, you can still make it pop and bang, softly of course, but hey. And last thing for today, the new E63S AMG comes with an integrated dashcam in the front. Useful for crashes and for your track day. So, If you had, or if you have, 100,000 euros, then you would still need some more, but would you buy one of these? I mean, I can only speak for myself, and I would, yeah, it's a bit expensive, but I would totally get it. And look at what you get for your money. So leave me your thoughts and ideas for the next cars, stay safe out there, and as always, keep it fluid.